Hi everyone, I hope you're good. This is Sharik and this is gonna be another Lebanese Arabic lesson. You know by now, whoever follows my lessons, that when I say it's a Lebanese Arabic lesson, it means it's also a Levantine Arabic lesson, because Levantine is the dialect spoken in Lebanon, Jordan, Palestine and Syria, and the Lebanese dialect falls under the same category. Yalla, before I begin, and by the time people join, I want to let you know about my 30-day challenge courses, which are pre-recorded 30-day challenge courses. You know, I upload lots of lessons on YouTube. So what makes these lessons different from the ones that I put on YouTube? The difference is that they are very structured and they lead you from point A to point B to point C, from one point to another. So if you want to learn Arabic and specifically a spoken dialect with structure, then the 30-day challenge is a great choice. As the name says it, it's a program for 30 days. You will be studying every single day and you receive pre-recorded video lessons. You also receive lots of audio material and PDF material that you can use outside of the lessons. You have lifetime access to these lessons, and also even the notes that we randomly talk about in class, they are all written and recorded with my voice as well. So if this is something that you are interested in, nyalla, get in touch, and let's begin with our lesson today. Let me see if there's anyone here. There's only one person so far. Just let me know if the voice is good as well. What else can we say until people join? Also, actually, if you want to learn Arabic with a little bit more fun, you can go to my TikTok page, where I upload every day like two videos at least, very short lessons, like fun lessons, sometimes expressions, sometimes, you know, just phrases that we use a lot in Lebanon. So it's nice to you know, break the ice as well and go there. And with regards to the 30-day challenge as well, what is good about it is that you can do it at any time of the day, because, you know, we're going back to normal life and it's not easy to commit every day at the same time. You know, we're not staying home anymore. So this way you can do it at any time you want. And throughout the week, there will be Q&A sessions where you can come ask questions. We can see each other's faces and yeah, we can learn together as well. Yalla khalas, I'm gonna begin. I'm gonna start as usual by reading this a little bit fast with normal speed, and then I'm gonna read it slowly and break it down. This is what I did today. I thought I can share it with you because there is a big storm in London today and we are kind of stuck at home. So yalla, I'll read it. اليوم في عاصفة بلندن. اليوم. Okay, actually, before I begin, sorry, I keep on talking a lot. If you know how to read Arabic, please ignore the left-hand side. Don't get used to it, okay? And whoever is getting used to just reading the left-hand side with the Roman alphabet, yeah, it's important because that's how we text friends and family members on WhatsApp. But it's also very, very important to learn the Arabic script, because you will need it when you become more advanced. You will need books and it helps you become more fluent. Yalla, bala tul sire, without speaking a lot, basically. Let's begin. So, اليوم في عاصفة بلندن. اليوم في عاصفة بلندن. الهوى برا كتير قوي. بيطير زلمة. كرمال هيك مزروبة بالبيت. مع انه كان عبالي اظهر شوي وغير جو. بس معلي اوقات الزربة بالبيت مفيدة. رتبت البيت، اشتغلت مع تلاميذي وصورت فيديوهات صغار على تيك توك. من بعدها تغديت شورب بتلوبيا وبندورة أنا وعم بحكي مع بنت عمتي. بس خلصت معها تلفنت لأمي وبيي بلبنان وعملنا فيديو كول مع بعض. شكله بكرة الطقس رح يكون نفس الشي، يعني يمكن انزرب بالبيت مرة تانية. بس إذا تحسن الطقس بظهر شوي وبشوف أصحابي. هلأ بس خلص معكن بركي بعمل جوت بوشار، بحضر فيلم وبنظم حالي لبكرة. وانتو شو عملتو اليوم؟ كتبولي بالتعليقات. يلا I'll read it slowly and every now and then I can check if you have questions. اليوم في عاصفة بلندن. عاصفة يعني storm. اليوم في عاصفة بلندن. Today اليوم today there is a storm في يعني there is اليوم في عاصفة there is a storm بلندن in London اليوم في عاصفة بلندن الهواء برا كتير قوي الهواء notice there is a همزة here in standard Arabic they pronounce the همزة they say الهواء in Lebanese Arabic we don't pronounce the همزة when it falls at the end of your word so we don't say الهواء we will say الهواء 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 and notice whenever I have an L okay make these little notes because they will make you sound more native whenever you have I think you can even hear the sound of the wind right whenever you have L at the beginning of your sentence you see and instead of saying الهواء you can immediately just say الهواء الهواء it's nicer and it's more native like you know الهواء برا The wind outside, برا يعني outside. الهواء برا كتير قوي, very strong. Guys, always say out loud with me. Always, all the time, like parrots, really. This is how you can learn a language, okay? Have a conversation with yourself the whole time, okay? And when you finish, write it down even. الهواء برا كتير قوي. The wind outside is very strong. بيطير زلمة who saw my TikTok in the morning can you tell me what it means when I say بيطير زلمة it's the full expression is الهوى بيطير write it down if you know it الهوى بيطير زلمة I posted it this morning on TikTok let me know and on Instagram let me know if you know what it means notice here I didn't repeat الهوى بيطير زلمة because already I said الهوى برا كتير قوي I don't need to say الهوى بيطير زلمة but the actual expression is الهوى بيطير زلمة be careful it's not بيطير بيطير means it flies شو يعني بيطير زلمة let me check if anyone knows يلا write it in the comment الهوى بيطير زلمة علوش يلا tell me what does it mean الهوى بيطير زلمة شو I sent you the video and you said you check all my videos شو يعني الهوى بيطير زلمة شو يعني زلمة I will wait because it's usually delayed with YouTube الهوى بيطير زلمة So I said بيطير بيطير with that pronunciation بيطير يعني it flies or he flies بيطير بيطير it's three syllables there's a فتحة on the top بيطير yes it blows a man away bravo Rachel so بيطير means to make something else fly literally that's why here in this context it means to blow away بيطير زلمة زلمة نفس الشيء نفس المعنى مثل رجال رجال is a man زلمة is a man بس زلمة is more like slang not slang but like more daily life way of saying a man okay a guy basically as well okay so when you say الهوى بيطير زلمة you're literally saying memorize it as an expression you're literally saying the wind blows a man away can blow a man away which means the wind is very strong الهوى بيطير زلمة كرمال هيك that's why كرمال هيك مزروبة بالبيت it's a very nice word to know مزروبة بالبيت it's a typical Lebanese word مزروبة بالبيت مزروبة is a participle in the feminine form يلا write it if you know the name anyone knows it it's the meaning مزروبة يعني participle in the feminine form in the masculine form بالمذكر ما بتقوله مزروبة منقول مزروب يعني مثلا علي مزروب بالبيت وريتشل مزروبة بالبيت شو يعني مزروب ومزروبة the closest yeah bloke would be a nice expression for زلمة the closest translation would be stuck at home مزروب yeah stuck مزروب يعني as if you are stuck also is there another word more because I can say for stuck علقان علقان stuck مزروب is more like, you know, you had to, like, you didn't want it and you are, يعني bound home or something like that. Okay, so مزروب, it's a nice word to know. مزروب, مزروبة. So أنا مزروبة بالبيت, I'm stuck home. ريتشل أنت مزروبة بالبيت كمان؟ خبرينا اليوم مزروبة بالبيت أو مش مزروبة بالبيت؟ عندكن في هوا؟ So مزروبة بالبيت, I am stuck in the house, يعني at home. Okay, so let's repeat until here. اليوم في عاصفة بلندن. Today there is a storm in London. الهواء برا كتير قوي. The wind outside is very strong. بيطير زلمة. It blows a man away. كرمال هيك. That's why. مزروبة بالبيت. I am stuck in the house. مع إنه كان عبالي أظهر. Although. كان عبالي أظهر. مع إنه. Memorize it. Although. Now. عبالي. Literally. On my mind. It doesn't mean on my mind. It means I feel like, when you say عبالي, I feel like, مثلا عبالي شوكولا, I feel like chocolate. عبالي روح عمطعم, I feel like going to a restaurant. So when you say كان عبالي, I felt like. That's how you change it into the past, okay? عبالي, I feel like. كان عبالي, I felt like. مع انه كان عبالي اظهر. Although, I felt like going out. Now, كان عبالي, usually when you conjugate in the present tense, do you say أنا أظهر؟ لا, ما منقول أنا أظهر, صح؟ شو منقول؟ أنا بظهر, أنت بتظهر, there is a بي. Here's another time you can drop the بي. After عبالي, we always drop the بي. So, إذا قلت عبالي بظهر, صح؟ لا, مش صح, غلط. It's wrong. عبالي أظهر, I feel like going out. عبالي أظهر شوي, I feel like going out a little bit. أظهر يعني I go out. أظهر شوي, I go out a bit. So عبالي أظهر شوي, I feel like I go out a bit. You have to conjugate the verb as well. Okay, which means I feel like going out. Okay, so memorize it. مع إنه, although, كان عبالي أظهر شوي, although I was in the mood to go out or I felt like going out a bit. وغير جو. يلا, tell me شو يعني وغير جو. You have to be careful here in the pronunciation. By the time you write it, let me explain here something. It's not غير. غير يعني another. Another, غير. غير is a verb. هذا فعل. غير جو. شو يعني غير جو? Literally. وشو يعني غير جو? يعني شو المعنى المقصود? What's the implied meaning here? يلا guys, I'm gonna wait for you to write it. Okay, Ali is asking what's the difference between علقان ومزروب. It's a little bit, it's the same. علقان, أنا علقان بالبيت. But مزروب is kind of like, you know, cornered or something. I want to tell you about this word one more thing. But for now, tell me, شو يعني غير جو? غير جو. كان عبالي غير جو. I felt like. What? شو? يلا ناطرة أنا. إيه? I'm waiting. ناطرة يعني I'm waiting. شو? يوتيوب شوي بطيء. يوتيوب is a bit slow. بس يلا بنطر. I can wait. The more I wait, the more anxious I start feeling. شو guys, يلا غير جو. عبالي غير جو. شو يعني جو? I will give you the literal meaning. This isn't live now, is it? Yes, it is live now. It is. So عبالي غير جو يعني عبالي I feel like غير جو. Change, I change, which means I feel like changing. جو يعني atmosphere. But when I say I feel like changing the atmosphere, it means like I feel like, you know, changing the mood or my mood or, you know, just for a change basically. Yeah, changing the atmosphere. I feel like changing the atmosphere, which means I feel like a change basically. عبالي غير جو. Okay, so مع انه كان عبالي اظهر, I felt like going out a little bit, شوي, وغير جو, and change atmosphere literally. Okay, so كان عبالي اظهر. Yes, عبالي, it's usually أنا بغير, I change, بس we drop the ب. ليش? لأنه كان عبالي غير جو. I felt like changing the atmosphere. We also have to drop the be again because it's also attached to عبالي. بس معلي. But it's okay. معلي يعني it's okay. معلي. بس معلي. But it's okay. بس. But. أوقات. You can also pronounce it أوقات. فينا نلفظها أوقات. فينا نلفظها أوقات. Sometimes. أوقات. 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 الزربة. شوفوا هاي مزروبة. هون الزربة. It's the verbal noun. It's the noun actually, which means it's this being stuck. Okay, you're literally saying sometimes the being stuck. Okay, الزربة. We also use it a lot. Memorize it. أوقات الزربة بالبيت. Sometimes the زربة in the house, which means the being stuck literally in the house, which means sometimes being stuck at home. مفيدة. مفيدة. شو يعني مفيدة؟ يعني useful. And why did we say مفيدة؟ لأنه الزربة مفيدة مؤنث. Okay, feminine. الزربة feminine مؤنث ومفيدة is the adjective. Also has to be in the feminine form. So أوقات الزربة بالبيت مفيدة. Sometimes being stuck at home is what? Useful. Okay. So we know now مزروب, which is the actual participle, اسم مفعول. وزربة is the noun, being stuck. Okay. It reminds me of a word that's totally different, but I don't know if it's related to the same family of words somehow. I really don't know. It could be. But the word زريبي. زريبي. زريبي, where the horses live. Stable. هيك بنلفظها بالإنجليزي. We say stable in English, right? Let me know. So زريبي يعني stable. Not stable as in my life is stable. No, like where the horse lives. زريبي. And also, when my house is very messy, I can say البيت مثل الزريبة. مثل الزريبة. يعني or you can just say البيت زريبة. The house is a stable, which means the house is so messy. Like the stable where the horse lives. Okay? So, أوقات الزربة بالبيت مفيدة. Sometimes being stuck at home is useful. Let me see if anyone has a question. Weather, change of scene. Yes. It's not really the scene here. It's more like changing the mood. Okay. طيب يلا. يلا خلونا نكمل. Let's continue. So let me tell you what I did. So. رتبت البيت. I tidied up. رتبت. رتبت. أو فينا نلفظها كمان. رتبت. رتبت البيت. Always pronounce it with a liaison whenever you have the L. Okay. So. رتبت البيت. رتبت البيت. I tidied up the house. اشتغلت. I worked. اشتغلت مع with تلاميذي. تلاميذي يعني students. تلاميذي يعني my students. اشتغلت مع تلاميذي. I worked with my students. وصورت. وصورت يعني I recorded. وصورت. Notice here I wrote video hat. In Lebanese Arabic, we don't pronounce this ha, video had. We will just say video yet or something like that. Anyways, it's not even an Arabic word. We just took the word video and added the at to make it plural. So, sawarat video yet. Sawarat video yet. I recorded videos. Zghar. Zghar. Notice what I'm not saying. What I'm saying here. ما عم بقول صغير. لا. ليه؟ لأنه video yet بالجمع plural. So I'm using a plural adjective, zghar. What else can I do here? Who knows about the human, non-human plural? Yalla. What can I say instead of videoyet? Zghar. Who remembers? Anyone who did my courses. Whenever we have a plural of non-human, videoyet, for example, مثلاً. Instead of saying zghar, بدل ما أقول zghar, شو فيني أقول? What can I say? Yalla. قلولي فيديوهات. I'll give you a hint. Something in relation to feminine. Da da da. شو؟ يلا. ناطرة أنا. I'm waiting. شو guys? My favorite song when I'm live on YouTube. So wake me up when it's all over. Wake me up when you give me an answer. يلا. فيديوهات صغيرة. When I say it now, everyone will type at the same time. صغيرة. صغيرة. ليش؟ لأنه when I have a plural of non-human, you can treat it as if it's a feminine singular word. يعني you can give it a feminine singular pronoun, feminine singular demonstrative, feminine singular adjective, feminine singular verb. يعني instead of saying فيديوهات صغار, as if you're saying smalls in the plural, which doesn't exist in English, yes, you can use a feminine adjective and say فيديوهات صغيرة. Now, بالفصحى, by the way, in Lebanese Arabic, we don't say فصحى, we say نحوة. بالنحوة, in فصحى يعني, بيقولوا, they say, sorry, بيستعملوا, they only use a feminine singular adjective, okay, when it's a non-human. يعني, let's say, فيديوهات, فيديوهات صغيرة, it will be, let's say, I mean. Just in case they will use صغيرة. They would never use صغار when it's a non-human. But in the dialect, in Levantine Arabic, specifically in Lebanese, you have the option. You can use either a plural adjective or a feminine singular adjective. Okay? So فينا نقول فيديوهات صغار وفينا نقول فيديوهات صغيرة. وصورت فيديوهات صغار على تيك توك, on تيك توك. شو I continue or we continue tomorrow? يلا, let's do one more sentence. من بعدها, after that, من بعده, always من بعده, مش من بعده, no, من بعده, after that, تغديت, تغديت, literally, literally, you are saying, I lunched, okay, it's a verb in Arabic, we don't say, I had lunch, يعني, some people tell me, my students sometimes tell me, كان عندي تغديت, I had lunch. Literally, that would be a literal translation from English. But we don't do that in Arabic. We say, تغديت. Literally, I lunched. يعني, I had lunch. من بعد, after that, تغديت شوربة. I lunched a soup. But here, I'm not going to say شوربة. I will say شوربت لوبيا. Because it's a soup of. Whenever in Arabic, the mean, first of all, you can guess in two ways. First of all, it's followed by a noun. So almost 99.9% it should be with a T marbuta pronounced. شوربت لوبيا. Second, we call this an إضافة by the way. Second, you can guess because you're saying something of something. A soup of beans. شوربت لوبيا. Okay, so whenever, so شوربة on its own means soup. But when you say شوربت, you're saying a soup of. And then you have to say a soup of what? شوربت لوبيا. لوبيا يعني beans. Okay, a little nice tip I'm gonna give you that is used in Lebanese Arabic, not in Fusha, مش بال مش بالنحوى. لما يكون عنا تاء مربوطة ما منلفظ التاء مربوطة صح شوربة. And here we had a فتحة. But the moment we pronounce the تاء مربوطة, the فتحة always becomes a كسرة. شوربت لوبيا. اوكي مش شوربت لوبيا باللبناني ان لبنيز شوربت لوبيا مع كسره اوكي سو شوربت لوبيا السوب اوف بينز وبندوره اند توميتوز سو من بعدها تغديت شوربت لوبيا وبندوره انا عم بحكي مع بنت عمتي somebody remind me of why did I put the w after the انا من بعد أنا, من after my personal pronoun and before عم. Rachel, you should know this from our course. علوش, you too. يلا, tell me why. But meanwhile, I'm gonna explain other parts of the sentence. So, تغديت شوربة لوبيا وبندورة أنا وعم بحكي مع بنت عمتي. بنت عمتي يعني the daughter of my auntie from my dad's side. يعني paternal auntie. عمتي. My auntie. The word on its own is عمي with a T مربوطة. بس ما منلفظ التاء مربوطة لما تكون الكلمة لوحدة. We don't pronounce the T مربوطة when the word is on its own. But when I want to add the possessive ending A, ما بقول عمي A. I can't say عمي A. No, I have to pronounce the T مربوطة. لازم نلفظ التاء مربوطة. تاء تيل مربوطة ونقول عمتي my auntie from my dad's side okay it's not from my mom's side that's when it's that one is خالتي so بنت عمتي يعني the daughter of my auntie يعني my cousin so بحكي مع بنت عمتي I speak with my cousin عم بحكي مع بنت عمتي I am speaking with my cousin بس what does it mean شو يعني لما أقول أنا وعم بحكي مع بنت عمتي Let me see if somebody guessed the answer Let me check
Is it the same as Syrian? While am I?
Yes, it's while. The wow, it means while. What's your question? Is it the same as Syrian? It's very similar to Syrian because it's also the Levantine dialect, as I mentioned at the beginning of the video. Okay? I will answer some questions in the end. So, let's go back. هون. عادة, if I say أنا without the wow after it, okay? أنا عم بحكي مع بنت عمتي. I am speaking to my cousin. But when I have the wow right after my pronoun, أنا عم بحكي, the wow, we usually know it means and. In this context, بهيدا السياق, مش يعني and, it means while. Okay? أنا عم بحكي while I'm speaking to my cousin or while I was speaking to my cousin. And guess what? Guess what? Whoever is a little bit advanced, these are this is too much information. But if you can understand it, great. If not, you can just think about it for now and then it will come. Usually, it's if I want to say, I am speaking to my cousin, you say, أنا عم بحكي مع بنت عمتي. وبتعرفوا from the courses that if you want to say, I was speaking, you say, كنت عم بحكي مع عمتي. But with the structure of while, أنا و... We never use كنت. Notice I didn't say أنا وكنت عم بحكي مع بنت عمتي. No. I kept it with the structure of the present continuous, although it means like while speaking, while I was speaking to my cousin. So ما بقول أنا وكنت عم بحكي. No. It's still the same. أنا وعم بحكي مع بنت عمتي while I'm speaking to my cousin. أنا وعم بحكي مع بنت عمتي. The same sentence can also mean while I was speaking to my cousin. فهمتو? If you wrote, if you understood, tell me I understood or give me a thumb up or something so I know you understood it. Okay? Yalla, I'm gonna leave the second part for tomorrow. It's okay, so I can see you again tomorrow. Okay? Yalla, let me read this part. And slowly, and then once faster, read with me out loud. When you finish, write down the same passage. It's always good to literally sit down and copy a passage because your brain internalizes information. And also, if you want, would be nice if you comment under the video and tell me شو عملتو اليوم. At least one or two things you did today. Okay? شو عملتو اليوم. يلا. اليوم في عاصفة بلندن. اليوم في عاصفة بلندن. الهواء برا كتير قوي. بيطير زلمة كرمال هيك مزروبة بالبيت مع انه كان عبالي اظهر شوي وغير جو بس معلي اوقات الزربة بالبيت مفيدة رتبت البيت اشتغلت مع تلاميذي وصورت فيديوهات صغار على تيك توك من بعدها تغديت شوربة لوبيا وبندورة أنا وعم بحكي مع بنت عمتي يلا رح أقرأ أسرع I will read faster try to keep up with me يلا اليوم في عاصفة بلندن اليوم في عاصفة بلندن الهواء برا كتير قوي بيطير زلمة كرمال هيك مزروبة بالبيت مع إنه كان عبالي أظهر شوي وغير جو بس معلي أوقات الزربة بالبيت مفيدة رتبت البيت اشتغلت مع تلاميذي وصورت فيديوهات صغار على تيك توك من بعدها تغديت شوربة لوبيا وبندورة أنا وعم بحكي مع بنت عمتي Okay guys يلا I will check now if you have any questions any comments And yeah, it's okay, Rachel, if you forgot, you now remembered it. Yeah, I'm just gonna remind you guys, whoever is interested in doing a 30-day challenge course, whoever is interested in learning Arabic with structure, as I always say, it's important to have structure, a course plan. You know, day one, I'm gonna learn this. Day two, I'm gonna learn this. It's one point leading to another. I recommend doing the 30-day challenge courses along with the YouTube videos that you do. Whoever did it, Rosie, Ali, Rachel... who else is here? Whoever did it, yalla, leave a comment and let them know what you think about the courses so that they know. And the best thing about these courses is that they are flexible, totally flexible. So if you're at work or something, you can do it at any time of the day, anytime, and as much as you want. You know, you can do 30 minutes a day, you can do 1 hour a day, as much as you want, so long as you don't lose your momentum. You have lifetime access to them, which means you can review them 1 million times if you want to. You have lots of audios and PDF files, the audios you can listen to while doing something else on the train, on the bicycle, doing the dishes or whatever. And what else? The notes are also recorded. So, and the structure, mainly the structure to learn a language. Okay. So yeah, let me check the questions here and the comments. Hi from Istanbul to the person from Istanbul as well. Hi from London. It will be hi from Lebanon soon. I'm going to Lebanon soon for a month. Yeah, Zalame is quite Lebanese. I answered the question, what's the difference شو الفرق بين علقان and مزروب? مزروب is a little bit more intense, I would say. Yes. And yes, we can use non-human plurals with feminine singular adjectives. Hi Didier, hi to everyone, by the way. We do it in English too. Yes, you're right, fifth cat, it's the same as you do in English, like while I was doing the dishes or while doing the dishes, it's the same, right? Okay, yalla, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed it. And I'll try to come online tomorrow to continue the other half of the lesson. I send you a kiss. Stay warm, whoever is in the UK. And yalla, شوفكم بكرة. Bye. Merci.